It wasn't that long ago that Ben himself was going through a little bit of a tough time in his life. And he gets into telling me about this girl that he's been seeing at work, at the school that he's working at. And he just could not stop going on. Like, she's a sweetheart, so good with the kids, easy to talk to, super nice, absolutely gorgeous, just gushing about her. And of course, that girl was Maddie. And despite this being a bit of a turbulent time in his life and really not too sure where he was going, I think it was clear from that moment that he'd already decided that she was the one. And needless to say, with all of us being here gathered today to celebrate them, that was the best decision he's ever made in his life.
Tiptoed in a room, I know you got to have your rest. She says, come lay beside me, I've been waiting since you left.
Maddie, or Manny, as I used to say, for 27 years, I've looked up to you. You've been my best friend, my babysitter, travel buddy, workout partner, golf partner, go-to advice giver, and forever my best friend. When we were kids, I always wanted to be like you, and that's never changed to this day. You are truly the most kind, thoughtful, optimistic, and joyous human being that continues to radiate all the lives in this room. Ben, I'm so happy you and my sister found each other. I know you weren't probably expecting to meet a family that's so obsessed over a cat, or the Christmas holidays, hugs, or that continues to harass you by the way you eat your food and the order you do, but we sure are happy to have you join us in our family. I cannot wait for more memories together with Mitch and I and our amazing friends and family that are here today. Benny, keep wearing fun socks. Maddie, never let anyone tell you there's ever enough pink, and most importantly, keep making each other happy like you do. I love you both so much, and cheers to the beautiful couple we're happy to celebrate tonight.
Marriage is a journey. Laugh, cherish the little things. Be kind and do things for each other just because. They don't have to be big gestures, whether it's stealing the neighbor's flowers and pawning them off as your own. It doesn't matter. It's just because. I met the love of my life in Janie. Our married life is better each day. The face I can't wait to see in the morning, and the face I can't wait to tuck in at night. We're very lucky. I'm the luckiest man on the planet. And we hope you guys can experience that and have that love and cherish each other for the rest of your life. Where's my girl? Oh my gosh.
Hi.
Oh man.
Hi.
You look beautiful.
So do you.
My little girl.
Hi.
Oh, you look spectacular,
Thank
sweetheart.
Thank you.
My gosh.
You're cute.
I'm so proud of you.
Thank you. I love you.
A wonderful day, baby.
Just take me by the hand. I am the luckiest man alive.
Anything newsworthy that happens to my family, literally within 15 minutes, our entire family knows about it, and you all know what I'm talking about. It's true. It is fact. Can't tell you what time of day it was, can't tell you what day of the week it was, but I get a phone call from my mom. She goes, so Maddie met someone. And I could tell in the tone of her voice, this was a little bit different than I've heard before. It sounded a little bit to me like potential. So obviously I said, yay, tell me more. She rattles this off like boom, boom, boom. His name's Ben Clancy, he's a teacher. He works at the same school as Maddie does. They carpool together to Lindsay every day. So I'm thinking, well, isn't this going to be a cute story to tell at their wedding? And then the dramatic pause from my mom. This next comment, I knew that you two were getting married, hands down. She goes, Lauren, he's a cat guy. He's got two cats. Larry and Hank. And at that moment in time, I knew that you were going to be around for a long time, Benny.
Oh,
Maddie what was one of her favorite Ben and Maddie stories, she said it was probably on their fourth or fifth real date that they'd gone out for dinner. I knew I was falling in love with him. He was a gentleman, and he picked me up. And as he was dropping me off, we sat in his car to finish the conversation.
Oh, no.
When I went to say goodbye, he leaned in to kiss me. We kissed, and then he said, well, bye, and gave me a fist bump. We couldn't stop laughing at how random and funny that was.
I go to work every Monday and get to do something I love. I make it home every evening to an angel God sent from above.
Maddie, when I look back on our journey together and everything that brought us here today, I can't help but smile. I'm so lucky to have found such an outgoing person who's not shy to push for what she wants. Your bubbly personality lights up every room, and everyone who meets you can see how truly amazing you are. You've made my life better in more ways than you know, and I'm so lucky and thankful to be standing here with you today. Now for some promises. I promise to try and match your energy each morning, no matter what time it is. I promise to listen to Christmas music in November, and to decorate the house with you far earlier than we should. I promise to give you a bite of whatever I'm eating, even if you didn't want one of your own. I promise to warm up your side of the bed and try and come to terms with your nook. I promise to be your partner in whatever life throws at us, and remember above all else that you're my best friend and the love of my life. I promise to be faithful, respectful, kind, and supportive, to cheer you on towards all your goals, and pick you up whenever you may fall. To protect you and love you for all my life, and do everything I can to be the man you deserve. More than anything, I promise to love you more tomorrow, even more than I love you today.
As I've grown up and thought about my future marriage, witnessing so many marriages around me, like our grandparents, aunts, uncles, friends, and of course my parents, they've all taught me the qualities that make up a good partner and in turn make for a wonderful marriage. I knew when I met you on that first day of school that you were special, that you have the qualities that I have been waiting for. I quickly fell in love with your smile, your silliness, your caring heart, and that you loved me for all that I am. You have made me the happiest I've ever been. Standing here on our wedding day, I promise to continue to make our life a happy one. I promise to make you coffee in bed on Saturday mornings. I promise to love you through all of our life stages. I promise to listen to your workday, giving my opinion when needed. I promise to make sure you find the little joys in life. I promise to lift you up if you're having a bad day. I promise to bake for you at least once a month. I promise to be the best mother to our future children. I promise to put our love first, never taking it for granted. And lastly, I promise to love you every day until forever. Thank you for being this amazing man that I get to marry. I love you.
Maddie and Ben, you've expressed your love to one another through the commitment and promises you've just made. And it is with these in mind that I pronounce you husband and wife. You've kissed 1,000 times, maybe more. But today that feeling is new. No longer simply partners and best friends, you've become husband and wife, and can now, in a moment, if you want to, seal the agreement with a kiss. Hold on. May the vows that you've both professed be sealed with a kiss and maybe a fist bump of everlasting love.
What did you say?
Maybe a fist bump of everlasting
Ben, love. Ben, you may kiss your bride.
Fine with three, wind up
could have wound up with weeds, wind up with a five-leaf clover.
Maddie and I are both so thankful to be able to celebrate today with so many great people. Today is obviously so special, but it wouldn't be the same without all of our family and friends. So truly, thank you all for being here with us today. Maddie, you are kind, honest to a fault, and the most energetic person I've ever met. And as Dad pointed out, that comes at all hours of the day. I don't know what I did to deserve you, but I'm so happy and lucky to be able to call you my wife.
I thank you for being silly and hardworking and passionate
and loving me like I dreamed about.
You make every day of my days beautiful ones. I'm excited to start life as you, as my husband.
And as your wife. I love you so much, Benny.
I've had all this sound I can stand. It don't matter to me wherever we are, where I want to be. And honey, for once in our lives, let's take our chances and roll the dice. I can be your lucky Benny, you can be my four-leaf clover, starting over.
So when you have children, the first thing you always think of is they're perfect. And when you watch the things they do and the accomplishments they have, it proves that you're right, that your child is perfect. And then they come home with a beautiful little blonde girl with a huge smile, and you see that she compliments Ben. You see that they're better together than they are alone. That's when we knew Ben had found true love.